revise the six-figure grid in brief once again, and then we are going to continue the next topic. Okay? Now, suppose I ask you to find out the six-figure grid of the temple year. Okay? So first you are going to write the four-figure grid. So this temple lies in this particular grid. So the four-figure grid of this temple will be 81 because it lies in this grid, and 17. The easting will be written here and the northing will be written here. The third digit and the sixth digit we have to fill it, so it will become a six-figure grid. Now, this temple lies in between, it's on the sixth division, okay? It's exactly on the sixth division. So, we are going to write the easting value, which gives you the forward readings, okay? So, we have divided this grid into 10 equal parts. We have divided this easting line into 10 equal parts, and we have divided this northing line into 10 equal parts. Each division is of 2 millimeters, right? So now we write the value of the easting. So 81 to 82, when we move, the value of the easting increases, okay? 81 to 82. So the forward reading. So this temple is on the 6th division, so the third value is 6. And when we go upwards, upward reading, okay, when we are moving upward, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, it is on the 8. So you will write the 6th digit as 8. Here you will not give the second answer. You will only give one answer because it is exactly on the division that you have drawn. So here you will have only one answer. You will not give a second answer to it. Is it clear? Okay. So first you will always give the forward reading divisions, that is the easting. We will go this value, the third value, and then you will give the upward readings. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 going upward. And this will be the northing. Okay. So this value. Is it clear? So this is how you are going to write the six-figure grid, children. Okay. Now I am going to teach you how to find out the slope of the land. Okay. Now to find out the slope of the land, you will see on the topo sheet, there are some values written. Like, there is a spot height 413 somewhere, okay? Then there is another spot height 516. There is another spot height 1172. There is another spot height 1273. There is another spot height 364, okay? Then there is another spot height 421. Then another spot height 261. Okay. So they could be a triangulated height 503. They could be a triangulated height 1114. So you look at the topo sheet all over. You will see the spot heights. You will see the triangulated heights. There may be some contour lines also, and the value of the contour also could have been given. Okay, 800. So when you see the heights and the spot heights and the contour heights all over the topo sheet, you will have an idea that which part of the topo sheet has a value of high height, okay, and which part of the topo sheet has low heighted values. Okay, so now you can see this part of the topo sheet, the value of the ground is high. Spot height means height of that particular point or that particular place is 1273 meters. This point is at a height of 1172 meters. This place has a height of 364 meters. So the spot height tells you the height of that place. Okay, triangulated height. What is the triangulated height? A small triangle is made and the height value is written. The word triangulated height, the word triangulated means that the height of this place is measured by the trigonometrical method, by using trigonometrical instruments. So the height of this particular point is very, very accurate. Okay, and the height of this spot height is approximate height. If it is written 1172, it could be 1173 or 1171 or little bit here and there, okay, few meters. So the spot height is not the accurate height, but the triangulated height is the accurate height of the place measured by the surveyor by the trigonometrical method. So now you know the difference between the spot height and the triangulated height. And contours are imaginary lines drawn on the map joining places with equal height. Okay, so this is a contour with a value of 800. So spot heights of same values are joined and it forms a contour line. Okay, so now you have an idea which part of the topo sheet has high altitude and which part of the topo sheet has low altitude. Now this is the north of the topo sheet. This is the south of the topo sheet. This is your east. Your right side is the east of the topo sheet and this is the western part of the topo sheet. In between the north and the east lies the northeastern part of the topo sheet. In between the south and the east lies the southeastern part of the topo sheet. In between the south and the west lies the southwestern part of the topo sheet. In between the north and the west lies the northwestern part of the topo sheet. These are the cardinal directions. Okay, these are the cardinal directions. You need to know these 8 cardinal directions. Now when you look at the spot heights and the triangulated heights, you will see that this portion, this part of the topo sheet, that is the north and the northeastern part of the topo sheet, has high altitude values. And as we are coming towards the southwest corner of the topo sheet, the values are becoming less, 364, 261. So your topo sheet slopes towards the southwest. So you need to know to which slope, to which direction your topo sheet is sloping. That means the land of this particular region is sloping towards the southwest. Is it clear? Now the rivers on the topo sheet will also flow towards the southwest. If I have a river here, the river will also flow towards southwest. Because whichever direction the land slopes, the rivers flow towards that. So this way you can also find out the direction of the slope of the river. Is it clear, children? You will see the spot heights on the banks of the rivers and you will come to know that whichever direction the spot heights become less, the river slopes towards that direction, because the land of that region will also slopes towards that direction wherever the spot heights, the triangulated heights and the contour heights become less. Is this much clear, children? Okay.